Greetings and salutations. My name is Artema, and welcome to something of a casual game design discussion. Now, this might be fairly long-winded, and I hope that you'll forgive me for that, but there's a long story here. There's a lot to tell you, because I can't just say I'm doing a thing. I gotta tell you why. I gotta tell you what I know, why I'm trying, like, you'll need to understand my decision-making process and stuff. Oh my god. So, welcome. Sit down. I should put on some, like fire and have a grandfather clock in the corner, sit around the fire, drink some whiskey or scotch or whatever it is classy rich people do in their reading rooms, sit in an armchair, chat about game design. Oh my god, that would be the life, wouldn't it? So, my name is Artema, and I am currently making a game. Unfortunately, said game is not a computer game. Whilst I would love to do that, I have little to no understanding of how these things are done. As far as I'm concerned, computers are magic. They're boxes of magic filled with magic that make magic happen, and I have so much fun because of it. And whilst I would eventually one day like to learn and become part of games development as an industry, it's not a thing I can do right now. What I can do, however, is make a pen and paper role-playing game, because the era of that didn't end years ago. Cough. Ah, come on, they're hella fun, and if you're not playing them, get on that. So, I like pen and paper role-playing games. That's kind of a big part of my life. Unfortunately, it's a big part of my life that is surprisingly small. Big because I care about it a lot, small because I get to play a role-playing game like once every 3 months, if that, because I just don't know anyone within the region of like a 2-hour drive that plays these games. I live out in the middle of nowhere where everyone is much too concerned with farming and football to pay attention to fun things that are nerdy, which is a shame. But, you know, you live with what you're dealt. So, I find myself musing a lot about what would I want? Like what can I do with the role-playing stuff? One of the things I do a lot of is generate characters, but the other thing I do is muse about what I would like to see in a pen and paper role-playing game. And I've even worked on a few. Not as in worked on legitimate projects, I don't do this as a job, but worked on making my own before. I tried to make one for Elder Scrolls Skyrim in space, like legitimately the future of the Elder Scrolls. Didn't make much sense, the rules were clunky and awkward, no one ever played it, that didn't get to early alpha. But it was a thing that I tried, and so yeah. Anyway, before we get too deep into the discussion of what I have made already, how about we talk about what my background is? As far as I'm concerned, that's a fairly pertinent element of the discussion. You need to understand where I'm coming from to understand what I know. I've played 3 different pen and paper role-playing games, not individual games. Game systems, game rules. The first, and the game that I've played the most, is a game called Vampire the Masquerade. Vampire the Masquerade is a political-based game about being vampires in a modern-day world. There's other ways you can play it, but it's almost entirely political regardless, because that's the system that vampires have set up. That's the vampire society of that world. People don't know that vampires exist, and they're very careful about keeping their existence a secret, because apparently if you're a wolf and the sheep don't know that wolves exist, it's easier to eat sheep. Weird analogy, but I'm pretty sure that's like straight from the rule book. Either way, whilst I enjoyed Vampire the Masquerade, and I think it's rule system, its D10 based dice system, is elegantly simple and just marvelously non-complicated to use, while at the same time having rules that cover everything that aren't too loose. Look, it just, it's got a fantastic dice roll system. It really, really does. The problem with it as a system for me is that it's very strongly based on politics. Its lore leaves personal identity. It doesn't have a strong emphasis on your ability to control your own identity. Almost every rule, because Vampire the Masquerade or the White Wolf books, the White Wolf role-playing games, they all use an identical system because they all exist in the world of darkness. Well, no, not all White Wolf books exist in the world of darkness, but all the World of Darkness books use the same system, and all of the games, Werewolf, the Apocalypse, Mage, the whatever Mage they're up to, and Vampire the Masquerade, they all have elements of you. This is your identity. It's kind of forced upon you. You can't really change that. You will develop elements. As a vampire, for instance, you will develop certain things. You will develop paranoia, for instance, because that's what old people are like. Old people are paranoid, is something of the suggestion there. And I'm a strong believer in personal identity, and I don't believe that even becoming an immortal blood-sucking monster would have the power to make me not want to have friends. And that's something the game disagrees with. The society of that world disagrees with. And whilst you can ignore that society to some extent, you can't ignore it to enough of an extent. And so it's not the system for me. It's a damn good system in my opinion, but it's just not quite the system for me. The other game I've played is way too complicated. It is a system known as Anima Beyond Fantasy. Now, this is something that's popped up on my channel, in fact, a few times. Once. I played one game and then did the short version down to 15 seconds. The Incredible Adventures of Step Lightly Drake, or something to that effect. If you haven't seen it, go and give it a watch, but if you have, welcome. That is the insanity that is Anima Beyond Fantasy. I don't understand any of the rules. And maybe that's why I have so many disagreements with it, but there's a strong sense of... It is a system built to incorporate and allow anything that you see within anime. I'm pretty sure that's why they called it anima, because it's very, very similar a word to anime, and it is, you can do anything in anime in this system. However, and this may be due to the GM I have, but it's got an incredibly strong focus on optimization, character optimization, that it's restrictive and unpleasant for me to create characters within that system. I don't always want to do the optimal thing. In fact, I very, very rarely want to do what is considered optimal. I'm just that kind of asshole. And so the system and I just don't get along often in terms of character creation. I don't like planning out my levels. I like to be able to go, I level up, what's available to me? Okay, I'll take this, that, and the other thing. It's also extremely complicated in the different things, at least as far as I can tell. The rulebook is difficult to get through because it's worded very poorly. Now, it is an early translation as far as I'm aware, or just not a great translation, and that adds an element of struggle to it, but I I don't hate it. I'm not big friends with it either. It doesn't get along with me. We just have too many disagreements. Why can't we all just get along? I just don't know. I just don't know, you know? So that is that game. That is what I would call a rule-heavy game, whereas Vampire the Masquerade is probably rule-medium. Rule-light game I have also played. The rule-light game I played was Numenera. Now, I only played it once, but Numenera is based on a system that's beyond elegant in its simplicity, because it's just beyond simple. There is actually, in the near future, going to be coming out a rulebook for a game called No Thank You Evil, which is basically Numenera for kids. It is simple enough to play with children. And that is both its strength and its weakness, because whilst the game enables anything, like dice are capable of producing any scenario, which is very important. Actually, that's something anima kind of doesn't always do, is have dice cover every scenario. Well, it kind of does, it's just loose. It's looser in some spots, like social interactions, than others. Anyway, Numenera is capable of covering everything and is really cool. It's just, I haven't played much of it. And it's, again, not necessarily what I want to be playing. I'd be interested in playing more of it with a good GM, particularly to actually get grips with what it is, because we had a few hours and no games involved, so we're like, let's just do this, because it's really easy to get started. So we really quickly got started and had a quick adventure, and it was fun. We went through a desert, my friend was a werekoala, even though he refused to admit that he was a werekoala. He was totally a cute and adorable, deadly werekoala, and got in a fist fight with a guy. I think he ripped his head off. It was kind of brutal. But Numenera is fun. That is my background with playing role-playing games, but I've also made a few, as I mentioned earlier in this sort of rambling discussion. The first attempt was The Elder Scrolls in Space, which was insane. Mostly because I had a really cool idea for a scenario. Necromancers were involved, as was a planet that was like lots and lots of soul gems on it. It was interesting stuff, but it was inevitably boring as a dice system. Like, it would have been messy and gross. Messy and gross. Beyond that, I think I've worked on a few. Most of them didn't get very far. I even worked on modifying Vampire the Masquerade, because Vampire the Masquerade, whilst I play it a lot, is very weak in the combat systems. In fact, there's really only one book that makes combat have any degree of depth, and it's still not good at it. It's the combat is shallow and uninteresting is how I've found it in Vampire, which is why I've been swinging towards having a game with more combat. I worked on a game called Arcanum. Now, Arcanum was an old PC game. It is a fantastic game. If you get the opportunity to purchase it, which you do because GOG exists, you should really do that, because that game is fan-frickin-tastic. Oh my god, it's so good. You should play that game a lot. It's hilarious and broken and unbalanced, and I was like, at one point quite recently, I'm going to recreate this as a pen and paper role-playing game, keeping it just as broken and unbalanced as it is. Like, at least for version 1, I want it to be equally nonsensical, non-functional, bad. I want that in my life, because the things that make it hilarious and broken are the things that feel the best about it. And I've not given up on that project. It's a system that I'm enjoying A lot, actually. I've made a D20 or two D20 based dice roll system to construct the game. I've reverse engineered a lot of its most general mechanics. I now need to go through the Wikipedia page and get all the content translated to my version. And that's a monumental task. And I kind of slightly lost interest. There's also the magic system. The magic system for that game feels a little weak because of engine difficulties, I'm guessing, when they were creating the computer version. And there's just spells that just don't, like, there is a spell called Hardened Hands. It's supposed to make you hit stuff harder with when you're punching, like, unarmed, you're supposed to deal more damage. It has no function. The game registers that you've got a spell currently channeled, but it doesn't do anything. And I've got to deal with all of that nonsense. Oh my god. Also, its technological aspects. Whilst good for a computer game, not great for a pen and paper. But either way, we still working on that project. That will run concurrently with what I'm currently doing. It's an interesting game and an interesting idea to go, well, I'm going to reverse engineer something. And I think that was kind of what got me to the skill level in writing rule books, that I think I'm confident enough to attempt to make my own thing, even though that's not a finished project. Onwards to my own thing, the last topic for this little casual discussion, because this is the prelude, the prequel to actually talking about the game design itself. So how much do you like robots? Big robots, small robots, tiny robots, massive robots. How much do you like them? Have you seen Pacific Rim? Because I have, and that's my favorite movie of all time. Sure, it's flawed, but it quickly overtook whatever was my previous favorite movie of all time, because it turns out I really like giant CGI thing hits other giant CGI thing. It's beautiful and magical and, oh, could just watch that show forever. Oh well, hope, like, if it had new content forever. But I get bored of seeing exactly the same things again and again and again. Eventually. I also recently played Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, and that game is batshit insane. Legitimately off its nut, on all sorts of drugs. All sorts of drugs was that game. Nothing made sense. Everything was beautiful. Giant robots got beat up by a smaller robot. Smaller robots sometimes got beat up by the bigger robots because I was bad and didn't really understand some of the game mechanics until I'd played it like twice through. But it was so much fun and I love that game. I'm also big into robots in fighting anime, or robot fighting in anime, as Code Geass is like a thing I like a lot, watch too many times. I haven't seen many other robot fighting in animes, but I know it exists, and Zoids! Oh my god, Zoids. Zoids is great. This may seem all off topic right now, but I'm gonna put it back on topic. I am making that the anime. Not the anime, sorry. I am making that the pen and paper game. If anima is anime in a pen and paper, with, like, generally an emphasis on being magical rather than technological, although generally. I want to make Pacific Rim meets Zoids meets Metal Gear Rising Revengeance meets Code Geass all in one great big rules medium, preferably, pen and paper role-playing game. I want robots to hit other robots, I want the pilots to have cool nicknames and scream insane nonsense as they do their special techniques. And I want people to have the freedom to create the robot of their imagination, with the arsenal of their imagination. I want personalized fighting machines. And that's what I'm doing. I've been working on it for a month or two now. It's proving to be a really enjoyable project. It's in an early alpha build that I could, once I actually generate some content for it, could totally, like, play a game, which I actually intend on doing nearish in the future. That's the goal. And the goal of this discussion, well, the goal of this discussion is to tell you about it, let you know, because I intend on bringing you guys with me. You can witness my endeavor. Yeah, at exactly the rate it occurs. I will try and keep my progress regular, but progress updates may not be if things are getting to really boring segments. But I just want to talk to you about where I'm coming from and discuss game mechanics and game design and why I'm making the decisions I'm making, why I'm constructing the game that I'm the way I'm constructing it, and give you overviews and just talk to you about it. And if you want, you can chime in on and help and contribute to the development of robots hitting other robots. I don't know if there's already pen and papers that do this. I don't know if I'm accidentally recreating a game that already exists. That would suck, wouldn't it? Because then I'd put a whole lot of time and effort into developing a thing to find that I could never actually release it because someone already developed that exact same thing. I don't really care. I'm doing this project for my own fun. I'm creating this project because I want people to have the enjoyment of smashing other people's robots with their robots. And I want any mechanized combat vehicle to be entirely viable within this system. Well, not entirely viable, but like mechanically viable. You can have it. Whether or not it works is up to you. Up to the dice, I suppose. So that's what this is. I hope you will join me on this marvelous adventure of clashing machinery and, you know, just fires in your cockpit destroying your life. And I will see you when it comes time, when I decide to do the next video, to just let you know more about the project itself. Thank you for listening. Have a lovely day. Good night.